I wanted to talk for a couple minutes about the VDAP, the Vapor Detector Annunciator Panel. And I have to kind of be a little quiet because there's a tour going on in the control center right over there. So the VDAP, this little thing right up here, you probably never notice this when you come on a tour. Next time you take a tour, make a point. We're between blast doors 8 and 9 in the blast lock. So where you came in is right over here. All right, so just to get your bearings, come through door 6, door 7, and you're in the blast lock junction. VDAP is right up here. What this thing is, it's the readout for some equipment down on silo level 6 that's doing a constant real-time chemical analysis of the air in the silo and the silo equipment area, looking for propellant vapor, right? Because if you begin to sniff propellant vapor, then you know that you got a serious problem on your hands. That'd be handy to know about that in advance. So before the crew would ever open blast door 9, right here, because that's the silo is the next stop, right? Before you open that door, you look at the VDAP to make sure that all the meters are reading 0. And you would actually come over here and you'd rotate this switch through the 8 positions that are the 8 different sensor levels or sensor positions of the VDAP. And if you get any reading at all on the meter, you don't open the blast door. You just go back into control center and call for help. So let's go down to silo level 6 and see where the actual equipment that runs this is located. Okay, we're on level 6 of the silo, and this is where the equipment is that runs the VDAP, the Vapor Detector Annunciator Panel. And that equipment is called the MSA equipment because it's made by the Mine Safety Appliance Company. So crew always call it the MSA equipment. Some of the more pesky equipment on the complex, I think in the archives we have a file about this big full of modifications and fixes to it. It was either too sensitive or not sensitive enough, or all kinds of things could go wrong. All right, so all the sampling comes in through rubber, well, or some kind of rubber, little tubes like this. And all these tubes go into the MSA equipment right up here on both sides. There's two big panels here. One of the panels is looking for oxidizer vapor. The other panel is looking for fuel vapor. So I can open this up for, oh, by the way, it says toxic vapor opens slowly, then stand clear. The reason for that is that this equipment used a gaseous reagent chemical. It was in a big, one of those big metal tanks, like a acetylene cylinder. It was right here. And that stuff, I've been told the name a dozen times. It's one of those big, organic chemical names like acetophilic something. Anyway, that stuff is not poison, but it'll make you sick if you inhale too much of it. So that's why they have the warning. So inside, there isn't much to see. There was a vacuum pump in here that actually did the sampling, and it was located, I think, right here. And it has been removed now, unfortunately. But all of this stuff here, and then this thing is like, see the radiation symbol on there? It's like a smoke detector. Believe it or not, the smoke detector in your home is mildly radioactive. In the old days, this used a little bit of radium in there, which is, really radioactive. And then later on, they replaced it with americium, which is what's in your smoke detector today. Now, today, both of those things are gone, so there's nothing inside here that's radioactive. But it was a little like the smoke detector in your home. And then this worked some other way. And they would use this to sample the air and do a chemical analysis and figure out if there were, in this case, any fuel vapors present. So take a look on the other side. Step up on the platform here. This is a shock-isolated platform. And let's talk about these big plastic bags right here. These are used to actually calibrate the system. So what you would do is you'd have a little glass ampule full of either fuel or oxidizer, and you'd put it in a bag, and you'd crush it once it was in there. And that would create a known concentration inside the bag. And then you connect this to a spare hose right here, and you could use that to calibrate the system. So on the other side, these are manual sampling controls. You can turn a knob here, and these are absolutely beautiful indicator lights. They don't make them like this anymore. These are actually fluted glass. This is really something. Anyway, these are manual sample points, so you can dial in whatever point it is you want to look at. These are meters that indicate how much is present, and they have a little, these are called relay meters, so you can actually set them for a particular value, and when the meter gets to that value, it'll set off an alarm or something. And then later in the program, they installed what was called the Billionaire Analyzer. And the Billionaire Analyzer is like a mass spectrometer is what it is. So it's a much more sophisticated method of looking for gaseous vapors than the old method was. And these were equally fussy in that they would go off when they weren't supposed to, setting an alarm off. Remember, these had the ability to turn on water sprays inside where the missile is, inside the silo, because if vapors got too high, one way of dealing with that was to flood the whole thing with water. And if that happened accidentally, that was a huge problem. So the system worked pretty well, but they were always making mods and fixes and stuff to it over the years. So anyway, that's a quick overview of the MSA equipment connected to the VDAP up in the blast lock. Thanks for watching.